So if they don't believe me, I will give them all of the information, all of it. And the fact is, this is very real. They have right now been able to successfully clone super soldiers since 1982. They've been working on cloning since 1927 in Germany. They started their research. They started doing a successful human cloning in 1967. They were doing research at the University of Chicago. It was one of the main centers here and overseas in Moscow at the Moscow Institute for Biological Research. They've had parallel projects of the Human Genome Project completed with us and the Russians just around 5 years ago now. And they are very, very advanced. This is no joke. It's real serious, and we're in a post-human era right now. We're in a post-human era. I keep telling people they are focusing on other issues, and they're often distracted. They should be really aware that the overlords of our age do have advanced anti-aging technology. They do have super warriors. They plan on replacing all the police, all the military, with mech warrior robots, with humans that are literally converted to cyborgs. They want to directly wire them into the matrix. They don't even need to implant electrodes now. They can have direct thought to mind conversion helmets. These are real today.
Yeah, and much of that has been in the news. Just over the last year, and all of us, all reasonable people know that whatever you can read in the press is just the surface of what's actually happening.
It's the doorstep, the PhD
and that's
level.
That's just a reasonable conclusion. I mean, anybody would conclude that, but our own American history would prove that to be true, that it's decades after certain events where we've done experimentation on humans or whatever, and we wait until the principles that are involved in that experimentation are either dead or gone, or legal precedents are such that they can't be sued at that time, and then the government will finally release, oh yeah, okay, we were, you know, injecting people with radioactive isotopes just to see what would happen. That's the history of our nation. But when I started writing the Ahriman Gate, my research started taking me to the door of people who are at the forefront of this technology you're talking
right.
about, especially with regard to how the biotech field might actually alter the human species for various reasons, including military application. But then after the book came out and I'm doing all this radio every day, pretty soon some of these people started hearing me and reading different editorials I was writing, and I had some of them, the people I'm talking about, pro-transhumanists,
right.
wanting to talk to me about their issues and concerns. And something that's interesting that you just said is that we're on the cusp of transhumanism now, whether people want to accept it or not, and
right.
I agree with you. And in fact, I think that right now we are on the imminent edge of post-humanity, and by that I mean I believe that this could be the last generation of humans as we know them as the sole higher intelligent occupiers of planet Earth.
Welcome back to the Nutri-Medical Report and our special guest, Tom Horn. This is an important program, and I do believe we have callers, but hold off for a moment. The number 866-582-9933. This issue of transgenic humanism, we need to understand that in the ancient times it says the Nephilim came down and they came within women. It didn't necessarily mean they had sex, but they knew that there was a mixing of the genes, the creation of the demigods. We literally are facing in our day the return of the demigods. It says in our Bible, and you can go back and check it in the ancient texts of the Old Testament, if you get the Hebrew, Greek, your greens interlinear, you can see that the fingerprints of the watchers, the fingerprints of the Nephilim, the fallen ones that came down in Mount Horeb, are there. The Nephilim are returning, and they return when there's a galactic alignment of our plasma universe. We are approaching an alignment 2012, December 21st, the winter solstice, and there's a reason, because there are, quote, stargates that open up the astral planes so they can incarnate literally into physical flesh on our planet, and we are facing a grave danger, and our overlords in the New World Order are intimately tied to this great and dramatic and terrible evil that is coming upon our world. So it says, woe to you, Earth and you see, for the devil has come down to you. And it's not just a allegorical thing. It is a reality that is very ever-present, very evil, and don't be deceived. We are going to be literally on the cusp of a galactic and a cosmic war, which is happening in the heavens as we speak. So, Tom, tell us more.
Well, when we went to the break, I wanted to be able to provide just quickly just a little bit of fodder for anybody that might be listening to this program that supports both what you were saying and a little bit of contribution that I was making to that conversation.
Right.
And that is that transhumanism and post-humanity is a very real reality, and it's being funded. It's being much of it can just be read in news reports that people are paying attention to this stuff. When I was on with Dr. James Hughes, and he was the fellow that I mentioned just before we went to the break. He's the executive director for the Institute for Ethics and Emerging Technologies. He's also a bioethicist. He's a sociologist. He teaches at Trinity College in Hartford. He sits on the board at Yale University and other universities. And Dr. Hughes and I obviously come from different world views and disciplines, and yet we came to this gentlemanly agreement, conclusion, if you will, that mankind is now standing on the cusp of a radical future where the